Car Salesman Confessions. It's Elizabeth from the Homework Guide team. Welcome to part four of the series, How a Car Salesman Gets Paid. I thought I'd round up the series by sharing straight up opinions of current car salesmen and what they think about working long hours, their commissions, and whether they enjoy being a car salesman at all. So here's the big question of the day. Why keep doing it, guys? Why stay in car sales? Let's start with a guy who doesn't like his job. He wrote on the Motor Trend website, I once sold a car to a man in his early 20s. He came in with a buddy of his and wanted to test drive an older Mustang we had, a Mustang that had been on our lot for quite some time, but he didn't buy that day. He came back a few days later with the same friend, but I was busy with another customer at the time, so a friend of mine who was my floor partner helped him. At that moment, the deal became what is known as a split deal, which means that my friend and I would have to split the commission 50-50. Well, this young man was a tough negotiator, and it took us something like 4 hours total to close him, and we lost our butts on this deal. Ow. We sold the car for less than we had in it because it had been on the lot for nearly 60 days, and we were just about to send it to auction, which would have meant a bigger loss to the dealer. After it was all over, the young man asked us, how much did you guys make on this deal? I asked him if he really wanted to know. He said, yes. How much do you think we made? I asked. Oh, probably $2,000 or $3,000 each, he replied. He honestly thought that my partner and I had pocketed $6,000 in commission on a $14,000 car. The truth was, it was a mini deal, split two ways. We each made a whopping $62.50. When I told him that, a big smile grew across his face like we were pulling his leg, and he said, oh, no way, no way, man. You can't make a living like that. Tell me about it. Okay, so here's the deal. Because the car buying process isn't open, honest, and transparent, the customer has no idea how much they're overpaying or underpaying for a vehicle. As customers, we have to assume that because the car lot is a business, they're going to make money. And because they aren't trusted and don't just show us the invoices, the trade-in sheets, etc., all we can do is ask for the price to be lower and lower and hope that we aren't getting ripped off. Now, I know many of you do your homework, and that's the point, and good for you for tuning in. But the car dealers are shooting their salesmen in the foot over and over again because of this lack of transparency. Here's a pointed blog from a salesman explaining why he and others stay in car sales, even if the hours are long and the work is not enjoyable. It's a matter of perception and personality. One day you may sell nothing and make nothing. The next day you may hit a home run and make $1,000. Then you make another $100 and later on get a bonus from the manufacturer and make another $100. That's $1,200 for a few hours of work. Not too bad. That's what keeps the car salesman going. The hope that next time he or she is going to hit that big one out of the park. It's a gambler's mentality. But if you're in commission sales, you have to have a bit of a gambler in you. And now you know the rest of the story. Why it's so hard to trust most people in the car business. I can't even expound on that. This guy just nailed it. Okay, so if you go on Reddit, you'll find plenty of conversations and strings about how car salesmen don't like their job, and then other car salesmen jump on and say how it's not that bad, like a car salesman support group. Here's a few highlights I picked out for you. The first string is titled, I Finally Quit. After being in the business for 5 years, I finally quit. I made a lot of money this year and was able to save a significant amount to hold me over while I find something else. I just hated my dealership. It was terrible even by dealership standards. But I realized that the car business isn't going to be my final career, and I decided to quit and finish getting educated in project management. It was kind of scary, but I just couldn't stand being there another day. First reply was, if you want to sell big ticket retail items, look into a power sports place, you know, jet skis, quad bikes, etc. My company services all kinds of vehicle dealers, and those guys make a big load of money in a really fun environment with fantastic, compared to car dealership, hours. Sidebar, that's because people who buy that stuff are willing to pay for it and have lots of cash, like the people who go to Harley dealers. Another reply, agree, and will add, do not forget the RV industry. Those buyers spend stupid money on their toys. Another good post in the string, US sales, is titled, other car salesmen, I can't be the only one feeling like this, right? Is anybody else in car sales experiencing severe burnout during this time of vehicle shortage and customer shortage, it seems like? I've been in car sales for almost a year now, and I liked it when I first got into it, but now I just feel like I'm withering away here day after day. Comments include from a guy calling himself for a general sales manager. Everyone in this business has experienced burnout at some point. Either you stay where you are, try another dealer, or move on. Keep in mind that a customer reads you. When you're talking to a customer, smile. Even if you've had 3 bad customers in a row, smile when you're talking to the 4th. If you're money motivated, all it takes is one good day to get over being burnt out. John Garcia writes, the money is amazing, but the amount of customers I'm coming across is horrendous. I've only been in the business for around 10 to 11 months in a new city, as well as somewhere I'm not from, and it's first time selling cars, so it's taking a while to adjust. In my dealership, I rely on fresh customers, so I stand outside, regardless of the weather, hoping that someone drives in to buy a car. Recently, I've just been outside on my feet for 10 to 12 hours a day, getting absolutely nothing. Right now, for a month, I'm only at 1.5 units, but I've made good money. I'm just concerned how much longer I can stand being here with me having to rely on fresh customers. I do post on Facebook and message people in groups and set appointments, but very, very few have actually shown. Maybe 1 out of 10 actually show up and end up being no deal. It's a mental thing for me, I guess, getting tired of the repetitiveness. KTJ Bug replied, get creative. I moved dealerships in May, and although I'm not at pre-COVID levels for myself, I'm still over 10,000 every month with 18,000 last month with no deliveries, straight out of a very limited inventory and absolutely no base. I made over 500 phone calls, sent 300 emails, and 220 texts, so I won't BS you and tell you that it's not easy, but the money is there. Wow, this guy sounds like a professional, you know, like Andy Elliott. He says, working your service drive is particularly so easy right now, especially because you have a sense of what they like and can cherry pick to match out of current stock. Grind your GSM to pay out for a sale or straight purchase because we're so hard for inventory. Well, that sums it up. The guys making lots of money tell the newer struggling salesmen to keep their chins up and keep selling. Be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell and you'll receive a reminder right on your phone the next time the homework guy takes a fresh video out of the oven. The entire Homework Guy team is here to represent you, the car buyer, and that's what we love to do. Thanks everyone for coming back. We'll see you in our next video. As Kevin always says, you guys rock. I'm the amazing Elizabeth. Gotta go.